Timepieces are very satisfying, particularly broken ones. You can take them to the bench, take them apart, repair them, put them back together, and watch it run, and it's a lot of fun. I've probably been at it close to 40 years. I've probably had, well, certainly thousands of timepieces go through my hand, and I just kept at it. It's been a great hobby. Have you seen that watch, and do you know what it's about? My primary physician at EVMS, he mentioned several times about this other doctor at EVMS that was interested in timepieces. He said, you need to meet this guy.
Wow, this is impressive.
I think I have a mechanistic mind and I like fixing things. I've always loved watches, but I've had no formal training or skill. Larry could help me bone up on my technique.
It's called a clutch wheel, and if you don't get it right, it binds to this second wheel.
I've done a 2 or 3 year apprenticeship.
Mark has been a good friend. We've had a lot of fun with horology. That was installed in the Swordfish aircraft. He's a good student. He's learned chronometer work. He's learned deck watch work, military timepiece work. And later on, I needed a primary care physician. Well, it was nice to find one that knew something about timepieces and chronometers. I asked him if he would be my primary care guy.
Larry was probably made when many of these clocks were made in about 1940. And I really enjoyed working on him because you wouldn't think he was almost 81.
This is a ship's chronometer. It's made to keep very accurate time.
But he's very eloquent, he's sharp as a knife.
Mark's a pretty bright guy, and yeah, he has. He's been a good physician.
The human body is the greatest mechanism on Earth, and clockmaking is a sort of subsidiary of that. And to fix both these priceless works of art, I find very satisfying, but only when I get it right.